Oh, hey there, Valis.
Germaine, or is it Dredgen Hope?
You know it's Drifter these days. Has been for a long time.
I was just speaking with the deputy commander. She's ready for you.
How's she holding up?
Sloane is a soldier, and that role has given her purpose. Hope. But she has been through a great ordeal. Her own personal dark age.
Yeah. That's a bad hand to be dealt. Maybe this can wait. Unless you want to tip one back. Talk about the bad old days.
What is that? Motor oil? Battery acid?
Only one way to find out.
You and I are among the oldest of our kind. Centuries we've orbited each other. Why now?
Why not?
Maybe another time.
I think Keitel's actually mellowed that old wolf out a bit.
The plan's working. It's getting easier for me to parse Asa's thoughts, like a picture coming into focus. Other things are a little harder for me to wrap my head around. When I first heard of Saladin's iron war beasts, I didn't know what to think. We lost a lot of people in the Red War. The Empire took so much away from us, and now Saladin commands an Imperial Legion? They're the reason we had to fall back and regroup on Titan. Why I had to send fire teams down into the Arcology, never to return. Those Guardians died under my orders. They paid for our foothold in blood. When the pyramids arrived, there was no way in hell I'd give it all up without a fight. This is nothing compared to what others sacrificed. Completing the mission is how I honor them. Just like Saladin honors the Iron Lords. No matter who he leads into battle against our enemies. Stay the course, Guardian. Once Asa and I are ready again, it's back into the depths for us.
What's the word, sister? All this Golden Age tech is impressive stuff. Almost makes you wonder how they lost back then, you dig? About that, if we're looking to win this time, I need Savathun's swamp to wash up a few finishing touches for my rig. Cracking skulls and looting halls is your bag, hero. That's why you're headed to her throne world. That pyramid Savvy brought down, it's cut off from the witness. Scorn Bigwig's been digging tech we can use out of that burning heap. All you have to do is find him and take it. Then you let old Drifter worry about the kit bashing. Easy. Hey, one more thing. Zivu dripping nonsense in your head, too? She's been recounting some of my more heroic exploits. Dark Ages been on my mind. You know how the past is? You pull the trigger and people die, so you don't have to. Then, someone comes along and wants to forgive you for that, like it's fine. Won't ask what Zivu's dredging up for a killer like you. Wouldn't be polite. Thundergun's down there, though. Been under pressure so long, everybody's looking for cracks. Don't get me wrong, coin to table, she's been through it. But I don't think Sloane's looking to be told it's fine. Cause it ain't. Cause it needs to be ugly to win. And then, you live with it. See you on the other side.
Saladin Forge, to what do I owe the pleasure?
Just thinking about the bad old days, like you said. And that bar you used to tend at the base of Fellwinter Peak. You went by Wu Ming, as I recall. Made some coin selling drinks to the Iron Lords. Then spent it hiring them to do jobs on the side. Remember all of that?
Yeah, I remember. You left out the part where you threatened to burn it down.
Maybe I should have. I never asked you why you ran that little operation. What did you stand to gain?
With how your pack of wolves tipped their bartender? Not much. That place never got too busy, but I had my regulars, and they all had their problems. Some of them just weren't that easy to see from on top of a mountain. Maybe I wanted to call them to your attention.
Ah, so you had a better perspective?
Not better, just different.
I suppose I can see the value in that.
Everything's got value, old wolf. You just gotta know where to look.
This is tactical. Dive green. Fire team, Zivu Arath is directing her forces against our extraction operations. Make this dive count.
The more I commune with Asa, the more dangerous these will get. We'll be quick and careful.
I trust this fire team to get the job done. Make sure everyone comes back in one piece. Guardian, Deputy, scans show high-density fossilizations in your vicinity. Get to work and expect a hostile response. extraction sites in this sector are all secure. Let's press out a little farther. Fire team, you are clear to descend. How is our mission progressing, Deputy? Have you found any clarity in Asa's words?
Nothing concrete. Like it says in my report, still just fragments. I hope Saints All Field No Desk style isn't rubbing off on you.
No. I read the report, but I'd like to hear it firsthand as well.
Then you heard it here first. Deputy's recommendation is to stay the course and dive as deep as we need to. Asa can feel a horde of coral nearby. It's been harvested. Draw out whoever did it, and I'll keep reinforcements off your back.
Our target. Strike quickly while Sloan draws off reinforcements. Counterattack converging on this sector. You've been cleared to continue operations at a lower depth to evade their advance. I know Zebu Arath is a master tactician, but I'm having trouble understanding her approach on Titan.
From the time I spent here, coming after Asa's part strategy, part vendetta. The Hive see Asa as a coward, heretic. She tried to stop them from finding the other worms. It's not enough to banish her. She has to die. Your ghost on that gear. Let's see how they like a little sabotage.
counterattack converging on this sector. You've been cleared to continue operations at a lower depth to evade their advance.
All Egregore samples are safe in containment. Ready to punch a hole out of here?
You know, this guy's pretty resilient. Wouldn't make a bad primeval.
Wizard you defeated. Zivul Wrath howled their name. Kudazad. I remember that from an old report.
Still have a mind like a steel trap, sir. Kudazad was a field captain for Savathun before Titan went dark.
And now they serve Zivul Wrath? Taken, scorned, wrathborn. She folds all conquered adversaries into her armies, doesn't she?
Not all of them. just the strongest, or those she's looking to use as a weapon. Not just to fight, but to hurt. Psychologically. She's defacing everything Savathun touched on Titan. When it comes to her sister, it seems more emotional than strategic. This is awful.
Sure is. You ever been outside of Seoul?
Never had a reason to.
Can't say I recommend it. Saw some stuff while I was out there. Bad stuff. A world colder than you can imagine. Creatures that suppressed the light. My crew. Let's just say we wore out our welcome. Creatures started closing in. Trigger fingers got itchy. Some of us froze to death. A lightless, final death. The others, they didn't go so quiet. Not until I shut them up. Not sure how long I stayed after that. Had to mod my ghost to survive. Used the parts from... I did what it took to get off-world. And now I'm here.
I'm no stranger to combat, but... How did you leave it all behind?
I didn't. Some things you carry with you forever. But eventually, they stop feeling too heavy to lift.
Thanks for the drink, Drifter.
Anytime, Sloane.
anathema. Calamity. That which cannot, must not come to pass. A wordless denial. A fleeing god. Betrayal. And escape. The pursuit for the final shape.
We're almost there. My link with Asa feels crystal clear. It's a little frightening, but strangely comforting, too. A lot changed while I was gone. It feels like the entire universe moved on without me, and now I'm struggling to catch up. Old enemies became new allies. New enemies wield the light against us. And old allies. Friends, like Amanda. Sometimes I wonder, if I returned to the tower, would it even be my home anymore? Or would I just be a phantom? A forgotten memory wandering its streets at night. Zivu Arath's voice keeps telling me I don't belong there. That the battlefield is my home. That it always has been. Maybe she's right. Maybe reliving what I went through over and over again is a way for me to stay in familiar territory. To remain in the hell that I know. And avoid the one I dread. Either way, the mission comes first. I have to see it through to the end, regardless of where I end up when it's done.
I see you. You see me too? Ha! Good, good. Then it is all working. You, me, this projector. Even if we sometimes falter. There is a war building in Sloane's eyes. One that Zivu Arath will exploit, as she did with Osiris. Savathun wore his face. But it was Zivu Arath who took his light. Her whips drove him into a frenzy, lured him into danger, forced Sagira's sacrifice, and left him to die. Now she twists my thoughts into thorns, draws out the faces of the suffering Elixni into my dreams. She whispers that I took pleasure in their pain. I see their eyes as they died by my hands, and they see me. She does not lie. She challenges what you hold as a strength. Osiris's ambition, my protection, Sloane's duty. I have felt how the right word, the right face, can incite one to violence. But I have changed. What she has taken, it will not break me. Sloane is no warrior of glass, but the war within her. Even stone crumbles under enough strife. Stay with her, Guardian, as I should have with Osiris. We must offer her what support we are able. Even if she does not want it.
ever forward march of time has a humorous way of looping in on itself. Doesn't it?
In some ways, a long-lived perspective makes it difficult not to see trends die and resurface.
Do you think that's how the Witness sees us? Variations of potential, or lack thereof?
What's really on your mind?
Sloan. She is singularly focused on her mission. That type of focus. You forget to come up for air. It's like a death when it's over.
Your command can be an anchor. Keep her from drifting. That's what I tried to do for you.
I seem to recall pushing back against your methods quite often.
The Dark Age drove us to extremes. Your style of leadership is more refined than mine.
It wasn't long ago that I was your pupil. Since then, I'd like to think we've developed a trust beyond authority or duty. How did you foster that friendship while being my superior?
You're not listening, Zavala. I didn't. Remember, you left my tutelage. All I did was give you the lessons I thought you needed to survive. Nothing more.
You're saying I can't be all things?
I'm saying I can't tell you what you want, because our friendship was not of my making. When the Iron Lords fell, when the Red Legion caged the Traveler, when the pyramids filled our skies, my heart was not open. You were. Despite your doubts, others see you as a pillar of strength. They're drawn to the shade you provide. Just stay standing.
Thank you. Oops.
Thank you.
are one, linked by the darkness. But only for a moment. I must borrow Sloane's voice to speak my words. Please, heed them well. Before you can confront the Witness, you must understand it. The Witness's first victims were once like you, struggling for survival, bolstered by hope, until their hopes became reality. They called it the Gardener, their deity of life. It ushered them into a golden age. For eons, they prospered. But their newfound god never spoke to them. It lavished them with gifts, but not with guidance. And though they lived in paradise, they came to crave a greater purpose. They desired meaning, structure, a winnower, to shape the garden. Their scholars discovered that the Gardener shared a connection with another entity among the stars. They called it the Veil, and when they found it, they arrived to claim it. They already knew much about the Light, how it could bend the laws of the universe and create life. But they came to realize that it could bring ruin just as easily. The cosmic events it set in motion could wipe out entire civilizations in a heartbeat, without reason. And so they saw the Light, not as a source of prosperity, but of unfettered chaos. By studying the Veil, they came to know the Darkness. A power that was shaped by thought and consciousness. And in the darkness, they found the means to carve away the chaos of existence, to calcify it into a final shape. Eternal and perfected. They brought the Veil back to the Gardener, in an attempt to strengthen their connection. There, they could reshape reality itself. The Gardener would not allow it. And so it fled their world. But they would not be deterred. Having witnessed the truth in the darkness, they used its binding power to merge themselves into the salvation they craved. Thus began the Witness's pursuit, its campaign to impose meaning on a meaningless universe, one that is nearly at its end.
Well, now we've heard what Asa had to tell us. We know our enemy better than ever. To think that it all started with the need for purpose. How that need became an obsession. What bothers me most is how much I understand it. This mission, it's my purpose, my reason for being, my guiding light. Without it, I'm lost. I don't know who I am or what I'm supposed to do. And that lack of direction, it's harder to face than 1,000 battles. I felt the same about my previous mission when I held the line on Titan. And if I'm being honest, it feels like I failed. I survived, but for what reason? What was it all meant to achieve? The only answer I've found is to learn what Asa knows. If I can do that, it will all have been worth it. Our link ended before Asa could explain how to get through the portal. The bond took its toll. But we'll both be ready again soon. When that time has come and gone, then I can feel like I accomplished the mission.
Never did tell me why you trust the Nine so much.
Oh, I don't. Not even a little. I trust Orin.
Orin?
Long story. The short of it is, I may have had a feeling or two for somebody a long time ago. Somebody that lost themselves along the way. But there's a little piece of her still out there. A sliver. Who still has a feeling or two for the somebody I could be. So I trust her. Because she ain't never steered me wrong. No matter how rotten I was. Because at the end of the day, maybe we gotta put our faith in something other than ourselves. Even if we're too stubborn to admit it.
I didn't expect you to put a lot of stock in faith.
And I didn't expect you to lose yours and keep moving. Guess we're all full of surprises, ain't we?
I'm giving you the benefit of the doubt that you're being genuine.
Oh, I'm always genuine. People just ain't always paying attention. For real, though, Moondust might have given me a push. Thought it'd help.
Sounds like familiar advice. Is it, though? Helping?
No joke? I think so.
Then we have that in common, too.